evaluation of crude drugs. Under this evaluation, now we are going to discuss about physical and biological evaluation. This bio, which is important mainly for the quality of the crude drug. Also, it is important for detection of adulterants. What are the physical evaluation? What are the parameters involved in that? Which, with reference to the physical evaluation, mainly it involves moisture content, ash values, swelling factor, extractive values, melting point, solubility, optical rotation, viscosity. These are the various parameters in the physical evaluation. First, moisture content. Moisture content, the percentage of active chemical constituents in crude drugs is mentioned on air basis. The moisture content of a drug should be determined and should also be controlled. And also, the moisture content of the drug should be minimized to prevent the decomposition of the drug, either due to chemical change or microbial contamination. How we can determine that moisture content? The moisture content is determined by heating a drug at 105 degrees centigrade in an oven to a constant weight. Example, aloes moisture content not more than 10% weight by weight, and digital is not more than 0.5. Then next, ash values. Ash values, what is my ash value? Mainly, it needs mainly for identification of the substandard quality due to either faulty collection or incorrect storage. The residue remaining after incineration is the ash content of the drug. That what it contains in the ash, mainly that ash which contains inorganic salts of carbonates, phosphates, silicates of sodium, potassium, calcium and magnesium, all which consist in the ash content. Ash value, it is a criteria on to judge the identity or purity of the crude drug. What are the various type of the ash values? Mainly, that ash value, as already mentioned, it is criteria on to judge the identity or purity of the crude drug, mainly which consist of carbonates, oxides, phosphates, silicates and silica. These types, mainly total ash value, acid, insoluble ash value, sulfated ash value, water soluble ash value. First, total ash value. It is total ash value. It is used mainly, what a significance, useful for detecting the low grade products, useful for detecting exhausted products, useful for detecting excess of sandy, useful for detecting earthy matter with drug. How to determine? Weigh accurately about 30 grams of powder drug in a tanned silica crucible, which made up of silica. Incinerate the powder drug by gradually increasing the heat until free from carbon and cool. Keep it in desiccator. weigh the ash and calculate the percentage of the total ash with reference to the air-dried sample. Next, acid insoluble ash. It is used for the determination of earthy matter present on roots, rhizomes, and also on the leaves. The crude rocks contain calcium oxalate crystals. The amount may vary depending upon the environmental conditions. How to determine? Boil the total ash obtained as above for 5 minutes with 25 ml dilute HCl. Filter and collect the insoluble matter on the ashless filter paper. Wash the filter paper with hot water, ignite in tanned crucible, cool and kept in desiccator. Weigh the residue and calculate the acid insoluble ash of the particular crude rock. Sulfated ash value. It is used for the detection of low grade products. Mainly, the name itself is the sulfated ash. So here we are using sulfuric acid in the inner while heating the drug. We are adding the sulfuric acid. From the sulfuric acid, we are getting the ash. That is called a sulfated ash. Next, water soluble ash value. It is used to detect either material exhausted by water or not. Example, tea leaves, ginger, rhizomes. Next, swelling factor. What are the significance? It is useful in the evaluation of the crude rocks containing mucilage. Also, it is useful for the detection of purity of the crude rock. Determination. Transfer 1 gram of the seeds to a 25 ml stoppered cylinder, means stoppered that volumetric cylinder, measuring cylinder. Fill up to the 20 ml mark on the cylinder with water. Agitate gently and occasionally during 24 hours and allowed to stand. Measure the volume occupied by the swollen seed and calculate the percentage. Next, extractive values. Actually, what are the significance of extractive values? It is useful for the evaluation, especially when the constituents of the drugs cannot be readily estimated by any other means. It also helps to indicate the nature of chemical constituents present in the drug. Also helps in the identification of adulterants. What are the various types? These are 3: water soluble extractive values, alcohol soluble extractive values, ether soluble extractive values. Water soluble extractive value. This method is applied to drugs which contain water soluble active constituents of the crude drugs, such as sugars, tannins, plant acids, mucilage, glycosides, etc. Example, aloe, not less than 25, glyceriza, not less than 20. Then alcohol soluble extractive value. That alcohol, it is the ideal solvent for the extraction of various chemicals like tannins, resins, etc. Because of that, this method is frequently used to determine the approximate resin content of the drug. Also, it is official method for the assay of myrrh and asafoetida. So generally, if you are seeing that alcohol, mainly 95% ethyl alcohol, it is used for the determination of alcohol soluble extractive. Example, alcohol soluble extractive, mainly aloes, not less than 10% weight by weight, and benzoin, not less than 90 if in case Siam benzoin, 75% weight by weight in case of Sumatra benzoin. Third, ether soluble extractive values. It is applied for the extraction of volatile oils, fixed oils and resins. Ether soluble extractive, it is two, one is volatile ether soluble extractive and non-volatile ether soluble extractive value. That volatile ether soluble extractive, which represents volatile oil content of the drug. Non-volatile ether soluble extractives, which represents the resins, fixed oils or coloring matter present in the drug. That non-volatile ether soluble extractive, example capsicum, not less than 12, nutmeg, not less than 25. What is the procedure involved in the determination? Water soluble extractive, macerate about 5 gram of the accurately weighed coarse powder with 100 ml of the chloroform water in a 100 ml volumetric flask for 24 hours. Shake frequently for first 6 hours. Filter rapidly through filter paper and evaporate 25 ml of the water extract to dryness in a tanned flat bottom shallow dish. Then dry the residue at 105 degrees centigrade and weigh. Keep it in a desiccator. Dry the extract to constant weight. Finally, calculate the percentage weight by weight of water soluble extractive value with reference to the air dried drug. Already the example mentioned in the previous slide. Alcohol soluble extractive, the procedure involved in that. Macerate about 5 gram of the accurately weighed coarse powder with 100 ml of alcohol in a 100 ml stoppered flask for 24 hours. Shake frequently for 6 hours. Filter rapidly through filter paper and collect the filtrate. First 25 ml discarded. Evaporate and collect the next 25 ml of the extract. Evaporate to dryness in a tanned flat bottom shallow dish. Dry the residue at 105 and weigh. Keep it in a desiccator. Dry the extract to constant weight. Finally, calculate the percentage weight by weight of alcohol extractive value with reference to the air dried drug. Next. Viscosity. Viscosity of a liquid is constant at a given temperature and is an index of its composition. What are the examples for that? Liquid paraffin, kinematic viscosity not less than 64 centistokes at 37.8. Then melting point. It is one of the parameter to judge the purity of the crude drug. In this, these melting points are very sharp and constant. Example for melting point, colophony 75 to 85 degrees centigrade. Wool fat 34 to 44. Then the solubility. The presence of adulterant in a drug could be indicated by solubility studies. Example, if you are seeing, castor oil is soluble only in 3 volumes of 90% alcohol, while the adulterated form may show good solubility in the alcohol. Asafoetida is soluble in carbon disulfide. Balsam of Peru is soluble in chlorohydrate solution, and colophony is freely soluble in light petroleum. Next, optical rotation. Certain substances are found to have the property of rotating the plane of polarized light in the pure state or in the solution. Thus, they are described to be optically active, and this property is known as optical rotation. The optical rotation is determined at 25 degrees centigrade using the sodium lamp as the source of light. Example for optical rotation: castor oil 3.5 to plus 6, honey plus 3 to minus 15. Then refractive index. The definition very important. What is the definition for refractive index? When a ray of light passes from one medium to another of different density, it is bent from original path. Thus, the ratio of the velocity of light in vacuum to its velocity in the substance is termed as refractive index of the second medium. Depending upon the purity, it is constant for a liquid and can be considered as one of the criteria for its standardization. Mainly, this refractive index of the compounds are for sodium light and at temperature, mainly at temperature it is 25 degree centigrade. Some examples for refractive index: Arrakis oil 1.4678 to 1.470, castor oil 1.4758 to 1.527. Then volatile oil content. Volatile oil content, mainly it is analyzed or extracted by using steam distillation. Example for volatile oil content: it is clove not less than 15% weight by weight, fennel not less than 1.4. Mainly for volatile oil, to distill the volatile oil, the apparatus used for the volatile oil, that is Clavages apparatus, mainly that only used with the help of Clavages apparatus. It is fitted with the RB flask, which includes the particular crude drug, and add the water, boil for minimum 3 hours. We can collect and the Clavages apparatus. It is attached with the inlet into tap, running tap water, and outlet into zinc. Then boil the drug automatically. After 3 hours, we will get the required, depending upon the weight of the drug, we will get the volatile oil from the particular crude drug. Foreign organic matter. The parts of the organ or organs other than those named in the definition and the description of the drug is defined as foreign organic matter. That is, from the original drug, what are the other things it is present in the original drug, everything it is called as foreign organic matter. Next, biological evaluation. These methods are performed on living animals, isolating living organ and tissue, animal preparation, and microorganisms. Mainly, first, what is meant by biological bioassay? So, when the estimation of potency of the crude drug or its preparation is done by means of its either on living organisms like bacteria, fungal growth or animal tissue or entire animal, it is known as bioassay. Mainly, this bioassay adequately done by chemical or physical means and also for confirmatory of therapeutic activity of the raw material and finished product. Mainly, what are the significance? In this method, it is generally used when standardization is not done satisfactory by chemical or physical method. When the quantity of the drug or sample are very less than the drugs are evaluated by biological method. Example, mainly these biologicals, this activity, it is represented in units known as IU, that is called International Units. The specific biological activity contained in each international unit of the few drugs are digitalis. One international unit is contained in 76 milligram of standard preparation. Vitamin A, one international unit is present in 0.344 micrograms of standard preparation. And biological testing of the drug. Mainly, what are the biological testing? Mainly, in these various biological testing, everything it is done in the biological assays. Mainly, in the biological assays, three types are there. What are the three? Toxic, symptomatic, and tissue methods. In toxic and symptomatic techniques, the animals are used, whereas in tissue method, the effect of the drug is observed on the isolated organ or tissue. The bioassay mainly subjected to used to determine cardiac glycoside, natural pesticide and antibiotics. Then biological method. Mainly biological method. What are the various biological activities which are checked? Anti-inflammatory activity, analgesic activity, and antipyretic activity, anti-ulcer activity, anti-diabetic activity, anti-thelmintic activity on the earthworms, cardiac activity on the frog and pigeon, then microbiological assays. Mainly, microbiological assays mainly done with living bacteria. Yeast molds are used for assaying vitamins and to determine the activity of antibiotic drugs. And mainly in the microbiological assays, if you are seeing two types of assays are available, mainly in this biological assay, one is couplet method and turbidity method. This couplet method is called as cylinder plate method. That is always called as couplet method, and one more turbidity method. In this mainly first cylinder plate method or couplet method. We hear assay of antibiotics is based on the measurement of the diameter of the microbial growth inhibition surrounding the cylinders containing various dilutions of the test compound, which are placed on the surface of a solid nutrient medium, which is previously inoculated with a culture of a suitable organisms. Then inhibition produced by the test compound, which is compared with produced by known concentration of the reference standard, that means standard drug. Next, turbidity metric method. It is based on inhibition of the microbial growth as indicated by measurement of the turbidity of suspensions of a suitable microorganisms in a fluid medium to which have been added granted amounts of the test compound. Changes in the transmittance produced by the tested compound are compared with those produced by known concentration of standards. What are the microbiological limits? some examples. Gum acacia powder, it is 1 gram sample of acacia powder is free from E. coli. Gelatin, 1 gram sample should confirm the absence of E. coli. 10 gram is free of salmonella and the total bacterial count is not more than 1000 per gram. Starch, 1 gram is free from E. coli and salmonella. These are about physical and biological evaluation. Thank you.